know anything about a book, do any of you girls?
No.
No. And as for the other, I couldn't do that without an officer's help now, could I?
Fern Smith, I'm not in the mood.
Oh, come on. You haven't got proof of any of this.
Haven't I?
No, because it's not true. And everybody knows that I have been getting my nose clean for the parole board.
Yeah, that's right.
Shut up, Birdsworth.
Yeah, keep it down, love, because she's not in the mood, whatever that means.
And the first charge laid will be for insubordination.
Well, you'll need a witness or two for that. And there happen to be a few people around here who matter, who want to see me get that parole. Now, what have you got going for you? The last I heard, you were being questioned for murder by the cops.
Be sorry you said that.
You haven't got a hope in hell of making any unsubstantiated charges stick.
Oh, they're true. They'll stick. And anyone else who's involved in her rackets had better remember that.
Are you afraid of the dark? Look, I'll go in and get it for you if you don't want to. No, it's okay. First shelf on your left. You can't miss it.
Right, you lagging bitch. Reckon by the time you get out of here, you'll be straight to the funny farm.
What's up, Nutter? You passed out or something?
Afraid of the dark, aren't you?
Don't be afraid of the bogey man, Brady Cat. Mummy will come and tuck you in.
Well, stay in there till you learn to behave, young lady. You can do better. You just don't try.
I do try, Mummy. I am trying.
Hey, Nutter. Are you there?
That scared the crap out of you, didn't it? Nutcases like you don't like being locked in cupboards, do you? I...
what's going on?
She hit me, Miss Ferguson. I didn't do nothing.
Is that right? And I suppose you're going to tell me she attacked you.
No.
Well, we'll let the governor sort this lot out.
Well, that takes care of Smith's work release. I don't think there's anything else. Thank you for your attention. Yes.
Excuse me, Governor. There's been a fight in the recreation room.
Can't you handle it, Miss Ferguson?
Well, I thought it best to report it while the doctor's here. It's Lawson.
Oh, well, we've just finished. Bring her in.
Come on, you two. Inside.
Right. What happened?
She went mad and thumped me for no good reason.
Lawson?
She locked me in the cupboard, Mrs. Davidson.
I bloody did
not!
Shut
up, Gaffney.
She wouldn't let me out, Doctor.
Paddy, you know now why you had that fear of dark, confined spaces. There was no need to get frightened or to panic.
You're wasting your bloody time. Doc, she's a loony.
Miss Ferguson, will you take Gaffney to be checked by Mr. Murray and then to solitary?
Come on, Gaffney.
Paddy, did you hit Margo?
Yeah.
Now, I want you to think. Were you fully aware of what you were doing, or were you just hitting out blindly to get out of the darkness?
Oh, I knew. I was locked in there and I felt sick to my stomach. But I fought it down. I made myself stay calm. I beat it.
Then why did you hit Margo?
So she'd think twice about doing it again. She's a spiteful bitch. I had to teach her a lesson.
I see. Well, I'll talk to you later, Lawson. Mr. Faulkner, would you take her back into the prison, please?
Paddy, good girl.
Now, what's the matter, Chrissie?
Oh, nothing.
Oh, come on, of course there is. Didn't do all those years of training for nothing, you know. Now, I can tell a case of depression from 50 yards.
Neil, the freak. Miss Ferguson. She knows about us.
Well, she was in here just now with Margaret Gaffney. She didn't say anything. And how could she know?
Oh, don't ask me. She's got her ways of finding out things. Same as she's got dirty ideas about what's going on.
Well, look... Don't let her upset you. Hmm? Don't let her get to you. Doesn't matter what she thinks. We know what the truth is, and that's all that counts. And people like her have to put dirty meanings on everything.
Neil, I don't think I'd better come and see you so often.
If you like.
It's not what I like. If the freak makes a report, they've only got to check the register to see how often I've been here.
Well, in that case, I shall give them some damn good reasons for your visits.
What do you mean?
Well, I'll just alter your medical record a little, make it look as if you've been suffering from some long-standing illness.
Do you reckon you'll get away with it?
Oh, I think it's got strong possibilities. Hey, come in.
Oh, well, tell me I'm surprised.
I've been feeling poorly, Mrs. Powell.
Yes, I'm rather concerned for Miss Latham's health.
I think you should be more concerned about her sex drive. What's the situation with Gaffney?
Oh, it's nothing serious. A couple of bruised ribs. I'll get the report to you soon.
Good. Oh, does Mrs. Davidson know how sick you are?
I don't know, Mrs. Powell. Probably if she's looked at the medical reports. You see what I mean?
Now stop worrying, Chrissie. Just leave it all to me.
Anyhow, he reckons he's going to do this phony medical report for me to cover.
Well, it sounds as though he's real gone on you, Chris.
Never mind all that. What do you say about Margo?
Well, nothing, just that she had a couple of bruised ribs.
Can you see how she got them?
No. Oh, bugger it, B. We get little time enough together as it is without worrying about a bitch like Margo.
What's the point of screwing a screw if you can't get any gossip out of it?
I've told you, I'm not screwing him. This is different.
I believe you. Thousands wouldn't mind it.
Hey, Mrs. Powell, how's Margo?
Oh, well, if you're that concerned, ask Latham. She should be able to give you all the medical details.
Mind like a steel trap, that one. Pity the spring's rusty.
Margo's in the pound.
How do you know?
I was there when Mrs. Davidson sent her. And I got lots of privileges for 3 weeks.
Well, what's been going on?
Well, I went to the rec room to get that quilt I was working on. And Margo shoved me in the storeroom and locked the door.
You all right?
Sure, I've never been better.
I must admit I was concerned when she said she'd been locked in the storeroom. It could have undone all of the progress we'd made. Luckily, it seemed to be the turning point that we needed.
I'm glad to hear it. You will be able to make regular visits, won't you?
Yes, of course.
Well, thank you for staying for the classification meeting.
Oh, thank you for lunch. I'll see you again.
Ah, Dr. Wiseman.
Hello, Neil. I'm just leaving. The governor is all yours. Goodbye, Mrs. Davidson.
Goodbye, and thank you.
You wanted to see me, Mrs. Davidson?
Yes. Mrs. Powell tells me Chrissie Latham has been making a number of visits to the hospital lately.
Yes, well, actually, that's what I wanted to talk to you about. I'm rather concerned about her. I think she might have a gynecological problem.
Oh?
Yes, I'd like her to see a doctor. Well, this is her file. The abdominal pains and the fact that her period is overdue are the main source of worry. Well, she might have a cyst.
Yes, well, by all means, call the doctor if you think it's necessary. You are the medical expert.
Thanks.
You said you'd have a serviceman round 3 days ago. There's a brand new heater and the house is freezing. Yes, yes, I know. Right, well, make sure that you do. Oh. Just a minute, sweetheart. Oh, oh, hell. Oh, shut up, Michelle! Hello?
Hello, darling. What's wrong? You sound a bit frazzled.
Oh, I am. The damn oven's playing up and I've just burnt lunch. What time are you getting here?
Well, that's why I'm phoning, sweet. John decided we should take the clients on a tour of inspection this afternoon and we'll have lunch at the club.
Thank you very much. After I've spent all morning cooking. This is positively the last time you do this to me, Peter.
Look, I'm sorry, sweet. But it has worked out for the best, hasn't it? I mean, if you have had an accident with the meal.
Well, that's Mommy. Hardly the point. Mommy. I'm going to hire that girl that came yesterday.
We'll talk about that tonight, Sal. I really don't think she's suitable.
There's nothing to talk about. I need some help.
Mommy! Mommy, I want you.
Driscoll House?
Is Miss Daniels there, please?
Oh, yeah, just a sec, I'll get her for you. Maxine! Telephone!
Better be the bloody bastards about me doll money.
Hello, Maxine Daniels speaking.
Oh, Miss Daniels, it's Mrs. Dempster here. was wondering if you're still interested in the job.
What? Oh, bloody earth. I mean, thank you very much.
How are you placed at the moment?
Sorry?
Oh, how soon could you start?
Oh, any time you like. Today, if you like.
I'd be most grateful.
All right, well, I'll be round as soon as I can.
Thank you. I'll see you then.
Well, guess who's one of the working classes now?
Come on, B. How about letting your mates in on the joke?
What joke?
Oh, come on, you know, all this matey business with Faulkner, the fags and the bickies and stuff. You're doing a deal with Screws.
Am I?
Of course you bloody are. You were always the first one to come down on anyone who did deals.
Well, this is different. It's for a special reason.
Yeah.
Listen, Lizzie, what you don't know can't hurt you, or me either, for that matter.
Do you reckon I'd lag?
Not on purpose, love, but I do remember a little incident when a certain Screw loosened your tongue with a drop of scotch.
Yeah. Well, I didn't mean to do that. Look. Whatever it is you're doing, I hope it's got nothing to do with that freak, because she'd do anything to stop you from getting a parole. And so if it's something to do with her, you can't bloody win.
That is where you're wrong. Because the Screws are in on it. Even Davo. Look, the idea is to get Ferguson involved with smuggling stuff in here. Then the Screws are going to catch her with her fingers in the till. They're as keen to get rid of her as the rest of us.
God!
But you mustn't breed a word of it. Because if you do, someone gets wind of it, the whole thing will blow up in Davo's face.
Well, I still think it's too bloody risky.
You got a better idea to get rid of her? Get me another gun and I'll shoot the bitch.
Here, put these away, will you?
Yes, Miss Fanny.
This is all the stuff, is it?
Made out the requisition this morning.
I don't like it at all.
It won't be for long, Colleen.
A few more of these and we'll have our fish.
Yeah, well, I hope so. Come on, let's get it.
How's the office work going?
Oh, fine.
File that straight away, will you?
Dempster. Sorry I'm late.
Oh, Maxine, thank you for coming on such short notice.
Michelle, you remember Maxine? She's come to look after you and to play with you.
G'day, Michelle. Oh, what have you got there?
A book.
A book? Well, that looks real beaut. Hey, do you reckon we could read it together?
Yeah.
Well, you tell me what it's all about.
Oh, I'm so glad you could come. This housework's getting beyond me.
Oh, you go right ahead. Me and Michelle will get along just fine.
Geez, Poppet, that's a nasty bash you got there. Fall off your naughty bike, did you?
Oh, she tripped and fell down the stairs. You know what kids are like, always in the wars.
Oh, too right. When I was a nipper, I didn't have any skin on me knees for years.
She's such a little sweetheart. Really worries me when she hurts herself all the time.
Ah, don't worry. She'll grow out of it. I did.
Yes, I'm sure she will.
Hi, John.
G'day. How's it going?
Long day. Be glad to get the weight off my feet.
Ah, the job's starting to get to you. I thought you'd been doing it all right lately, you know, getting a bit extra.
Hey, look, I don't know who's been talking, but there's nothing going on between me and Barbara.
Yeah, lover boy, I wasn't talking about your sex life. That's only one of the perks of this job. I was referring to your gambling arrangement. Now, don't worry, I won't say anything.
I suppose you can't trust any of these women to keep their mouth shut.
Depends how you handle them. I was getting my cut of the bookies' takings before you took over.
Look, I'm sorry, I'll back off.
No need to. Plenty of money floating around the prison. I'm sure there's enough for both of us.
You reckon? I didn't think there was that much. I only pick up a bit of beer money
here. That's because you don't push it. I picked up $2,000 from a prisoner one week.
$2,000? Well, who had that kind of money?
Hey, never mention names, you know that. Well, what do you think?
Joan, you got a deal. Morning, Lizzie. Sleep well?
Can't complain.
Smith, I want a word with you about your work release.
Oh, right, Mr. Booker. Don't wait for it.
Righto. Mrs. Morris has been making some inquiries for you.
What's happening?
She's taken the bait. She thinks we've got a deal going. I promised her a few bucks on account to clinch the deal.
Good. I'll arrange delivery.
Don't give it to yourself.
I'm not that stupid. That's her little courier now.
Can you trust her?
Don't see why not. Ferguson already thinks you two are on together.
Okay, be careful. Don't let anything go wrong.
Barbara, good little job for you. I'll just give this to Ferguson. Tell her it's as per the agreement. She'll know what you mean, but make sure no one sees you.
Why me?
Because if you don't, you know what'll happen to you.
Are you setting me up for something?
No, you've got my word on that. You're just a delivery girl, that's all.
Come on. All right.
Babs, it didn't come from me.
Yeah, well, what do I say if she asks me where it came from?
Just give it to her. Nothing else.
Come on, Michelle,
no, John,
eat up.
I agree. It's
come
too
on,
good to
miss. A good girl.
Right.
Come on.
I'll catch you later. Well, no need to rush to the office today. I've got to catch the 10:30 flight to Adelaide.
Oh, do you have to?
Yes, it looks like we've clinched the McManus account.
How long will you be away?
Only a couple of days, three at the most.
Oh, couldn't I come with you?
The baby doesn't travel well, Sally, you know that.
Well, she could stay here. Maxine could look after us. It could just be the two of us.
You know what I think about that girl? I wouldn't trust her with a pot plant.
She's a very nice girl. Michelle likes her immensely. You're just making excuses again.
I'm not. Anyway, you'd be bored out of your mind sitting in a hotel room all day by yourself.
You don't think I'm bored here?
Well, if you are, that's your fault. You've got the house to look after, Michelle to care for, and if that's not enough for you, why don't you join a community group and do some volunteer work?
You just don't understand what it's like for me, do you?
Oh, g'day, Mr. Dempster.
Hello. You'd better go and help my wife. She's finding it hard to cope this morning. I'm going to pack.
What's up with him?
Oh, nothing. He just has to go away on a business trip and he doesn't particularly want to.
G'day, Michelle. You haven't eaten too much of your brekkie, have you? You can eat some for me?
Miss Ferguson, I wonder if you could give me a hand, please.
What is it? Is that all?
I don't know anything about it, and I don't want to. I'm only delivering.
Fair enough.
Thank you, Miss Ferguson.
Morning, Mrs. Powell.
Morning.
Sally, is my blue suit here?
How would I know?
I was just asking. I thought you might have seen it, that's all.
I took it to the cleaners.
Oh, right. I was going to wear that.
If I'd known you'd wanted it so soon again, I would have got it back. I'm not a mind reader.
Any chance of a cup of coffee before we go?
Maxine, can't you find something quieter for Michelle to play with?
Leave her with it. She likes it. Yeah, Michelle, you should do the baby.
I put the dummy in the baby's lap like
There's no milk.
What?
I said there's no milk.
I don't know why you don't let Maxine run this house. Even she could do it better than you.
Yeah. Well, I'll go get some.
Good.
I don't know why we have to be at each other's throats all the time when you're home. We see little enough of each other as it is.
My sentiments exactly.
Mummy!
Oh, Michelle! Had you seen Mummy's got hot coffee here? Could have hurt you. Don't you understand? Hot. Burn. For Christ's sake, it could hurt you!
Sally!
About your work release.
You got me a job, Mrs. M.
Well, there are one or two possibilities. Butterfield's plant nursery are willing to take someone on.
Isn't that where Wonky Warner worked?
Yes, that's right. I believe Sid's a fairly decent boss.
Oh, I don't know. I don't exactly have green fingers. As a matter of fact, I tend to have the same effect on plants as I have on husbands.
Lizzie. Well, the only other thing I have, of course, is laundry service.
Oh, God, there's no getting away from it, is there?
Also, Mr. Faulkner's trying to get a job through his journalistic friends, but I'm afraid nothing's come up so far.
Well, if you wouldn't mind, I'd like to hang out for a while, see if he comes up with anything. I don't want to sound ungrateful, but I'd like to try something different.
All right, then, Bea, we'll just let you know when anything happens.
Ta.
What was that all about?
Job hunting. No, it ain't easy. Who wants to employ someone my age with all those kids out of work? I'll probably have to go out on the streets.
What would you do with all the 2-cent pieces?
I'll give you a ring when I know when I'm coming back.
Okay, I'll come out and pick you up.
I'll get a taxi.
No, I might as well be useful for something.
You got the keys? Oh, for heaven's sake, stay out of trouble when I'm gone.
Well, what's that supposed to mean? For God's sake, will you get off my back? I make one mistake.
I didn't mean it like that.
How did you mean it?
Look, Sal, if I can clinch this deal, it's going to mean a lot of money for us. Heaven knows I don't want to go charging off to Adelaide, but it's my job. The least you can do is to keep out of trouble and stay away from the scotch when I'm gone.
Yes, how much is this?
$68. It's imported from France.
I'll take it.
Certainly.
And you've got some snakeskin belts over there. I'll have one of those too. Take this too.
I
Any idea what the governor wants?
Oh, I think it's probably just a progress report. Listen, have you heard back from your friend about a job for B?
No, he's supposed to ring back. I'll get on to him as soon as we're through here.
Right.
Come in. Sit down, please. Now, I want to know what is happening about this plot of yours.
Miss Ferguson approached me last night with a deal to split the profits. She admitted she was collecting a payoff from the bookie and claimed that she'd once got $2,000 from one of the prisoners.
$2,000? No one in the prison's got that much.
Well, that was my reaction. I thought she was probably exaggerating, but I can't see why.
Now, I really am not happy about this cloak and dagger business.
Well, I can't see any other way to catch her out. At the moment, it's just Steve's word against hers.
So I can't imagine what the press will do if they find out about it.
Well, I don't see why they should. Besides, it does show that the prison system won't stand for corrupt officers. I mean, we've gone out of our way to expose her.
Well, personally, I agree with Mrs. Davidson. The idea of doing an underhand deal with Smith panics me. Well, we all know how much she can be trusted.
And believe me, for once, Bee's on our side. I mean, she'll do anything, and I mean anything, to see Miss Ferguson leave here.
Yes, that's what I'm afraid of. The possible fabrication of evidence. Well, Smith will be out of here shortly on work release. I hope that doesn't throw a spanner in the works. Is there any news of work for her yet?
Not as yet.
Well, I would like to speak to her myself. She's going to have to make a lot of adjustments if she's going out of here.
Come on, Michelle. What about talking to Dolly? What? Yeah, she's real lonely. And what about Teddy? He wants a cuddle. Oh, your dad's right. You're not a well little girl, are you? Come here and give me a cuddle. Gee, you're burning up, love. God knows when your mum's going to be back. I reckon I better get a doctor in to see you. Let's see. D for doctor. Dr. Kelly.
Well, that's great, Martin. Thanks. Yeah, I know, but she's been doing typesetting work here. Yeah, I'm sure she'll fit in well. Okay, mate. Thanks very much. I'll buy you a beer next time I see you, eh? Okay. Thanks. Bye.
Smith?
Yeah, I've managed to get her a job.
I don't know why you bother. She can't handle life on the outside. She'll either stuff it up or make a run for it. You'll see.
You're probably right.
I am right, so why bother?
Smith's top dog. Pays to have her on side.
Smith's not the kind of woman you can buy off with a few cigarettes and chocolate bars.
You know about that too?
Of course I do. There's not much goes on in here that I don't know about. What I don't understand is how you can make a profit out of it.
Well, of course I do, when the prison pays for the stuff in the first place. Why do you think I asked to be put in charge of the stores?
It's a bit risky, isn't it? And any discrepancy in the stock take, it'll be traced right back to you.
The stock will be as right as rain for the next 6 months. After that, they're going to have to catch me somewhere in the middle of the Pacific.
Hey, isn't it time you had some of your belly pains, Chrissie? Oh,
shush, keep it down, Lizzie. I'm laying off that for a while. The screws are getting too suspicious. I don't want to get near into strife, do I?
I thought he was going to cover for you.
He is, but I don't want to push me luck.
How would you like to work for a suburban newspaper?
Would I what?
Well, don't get too excited. You'd just be general dog's body. You know, a bit of typesetting, sweeping, tea ladies.
You got me.
Right. I've told Mrs. Davidson about it. She'll want to see you.
Thanks.
Well, looks like my work release is all sewn up. Forker's got me a job on a local rag.
Oh, great, Bee!
Yeah, congratulations. It's amazing what you can get when you cooperate with the screws, isn't it?
She's not the only one, Bee. A lot of the women think you're sold out.
That's so. Let them say what they like. As long as we get rid of the freak, I don't care what they think of me. And I won't be here to worry about it anyway.
good afternoon. Mrs. Dempster in?
Nah. Oh, you Doc Kelly?
Yes.
Oh, I'm Maxine Daniels. I rang you at the office. It's little Michelle. I reckon she's real crook. Got a hell of a temperature.
Oh. Where's Mrs. Dempster now?
Well, see, I don't know. She took her husband to the airport this morning, and I haven't seen her since. Mm. Do you know her something, do you?
Yes, I'm the family doctor. I've been for a number of years now. Long before Mrs. Dempster was married, in fact.
Mm. Strange people. Lovely house. Plenty of money. You'd reckon they'd have it made. But they're always at each other's throats.
Yes, well, shall we take a look at Michelle now?
Oh, yeah, she's in her room.
Hello, Michelle. I'm Dr. Kelly. Now, let's see what's wrong with you, shall we? There we go. Now then, onto your buttons. That's a good girl. There's one there. You've got two. I've got three. And there's four down there. Good heaven. What's happened to her?
Well, they reckon she tripped and fell down the stairs, poor little kid. They reckon she's a walking disaster area. But geez, I didn't realise they were so bad.
She's done more than just fall downstairs. Some of those bruises are older than others.
Yeah. Well, they reckon she's a nice kid, but clumsy.
Maxine, Michelle! Up here, Mrs. Dempster, in Michelle's room.
Well, she'll be able to tell you what happened. She was here. I only started yesterday.
Well, Dr. Kelly, what are you doing here?
Well, I called him in for Michelle, Mrs. Dempster. She's real crook.
There's no need to call a doctor in, Maxine. It was just a sniffle, I told you that.
Yeah, well, I didn't know. She seemed real bad to me.
I think I should have been called in earlier.
Oh, she's quite all right, Doctor. If I called you every time she had a mishap, you'd be visiting every day.
That's not what I meant, Sally.
I'm sorry I snapped at you, Maxine. You're right to call the doctor. Now, I suppose you're wanting to get home. I'll see you in the morning.
Yeah, oh, well, I don't mind staying.
No, you go. Lovely to see you again, Dr. Kelly. It's been such a long time.
A bit too long, I think, Sally. I saw your sister the other day. Came into the surgery with young David.
Pat's a wonderful mother. I don't know how she copes with the three of them.
Mm. Well, a happy marriage helps.
Milk?
Yes, please. Peter still travelling around as much?
Mm, yes. Hardly a week goes by and he doesn't go interstate. Not that I mind, of course. It's all part of the job.
Yes, it puts a strain on the relationship.
Well, we manage.
I haven't seen Michelle. I haven't seen her since she was a baby. She's growing into a very beautiful young lady.
Yes.
Pity about those accidents of hers, though.
I'm sure it's just a stage she's going through.
Possibly. I gave her a thorough checking over. Doesn't seem to be anything physical to cause the clumsiness. And the antibiotics will clear up the infection within a few days.
Sure, it's just a stage.
Mm. How's your mother?
Oh, fine, fine. Still pottering around in the garden, complaining about the weather.
She wouldn't be happy unless she was complaining about something. Gave you kids a bit of a half-time, didn't she?
Not really.
Let's see now. Pat, pretty hopeless at school. Jeffrey, always covered in dirt. And you, young lady, a cheeky little brat.
Something like that.
Now, your mother and I have been great mates for a long time. Well, I knew she was a bit of a handful for you kids. And I couldn't understand why one of you didn't turn around and give her a good smack on the nose sometime. Perhaps you started doing it now.
John Laws with indigestion.
No, I've just paid out a fortune for a set of science lecture tapes and the bloody machine's packed up.
Maybe it's the batteries.
Mm. If they are, we'll have to let the electricity board know.
Well, if you need one urgently, I've got one you can borrow.
Really? I wouldn't say no.
Sure, it's in the car. I've just had it repaired. I'll bring it in later.
Great, thanks a lot.
Wow, it looks good kill.
There'll be more dead prostitutes on the street.
You don't think Neil's the killer, do you?
Someone from the prison is. They stole my gloves to set me up. He's as likely a suspect as anyone.
Could have been me.
You were on duty the night the murders were committed.
I'm glad you checked. Anyway, it might not be a man. I've noticed Mrs. Davidson lately taking a few swigs from Dr. Jekyll's herbal compound.
You might think it's a joke, but I don't. In this business, the crims are always trying to set you up for something. I've learned never to trust anyone. And believe me, it's paid off.
Come in.
Oh, do you want me to stay, Mrs. Davidson?
No, thank you, Mrs. Morris. Smith, I've been talking to the chairman of the parole board. He's very pleased with your reports of good behaviour. You realise that your application for work release has been considered this afternoon?
Yeah, I know.
Well, he doesn't see any obstacles.
Oh, I'm so darn nervous. But I suppose my cooperation will go down really well, eh?
Yes, of course.
But I've never had a chance to say this before, but now we're on our own. I'd just like to say that I really appreciate...
Prisoner who's been in a long-term one is entitled to work release.
Look, Mrs. Davis, you know what I'm trying to say. We've known each other for years. We've always been on opposite sides of the fence. Well, always will be, for that matter. Nothing anyone can do about that. But I reckon you're about the fairest governor around. Well, there aren't many who'd set their officers and a prisoner to catch a bent screw.
Smith, I have no idea what you are referring to, and if I were aware of any underhand dealings between my officers and a prisoner, I would act very harshly. There would be no other choice. Do I make myself clear?
Very clear.
Hello?
Is Judy Bryant there, please? It's Meg Morris from Wentworth here.
Ah, g'day, Mrs. Morris. How'd you be? It's Maxine here. Jude's out. Everybody's out.
Do you know when she'll be back?
No. Haven't got a clue. I just got in from work myself.
Oh, yes, I heard you'd got a job. What's it like?
Bloody hoot. Fancy me babysitting a bloody ankle biter. But she's a nice kid, bud.
What's the rest of the family like?
Well, the old man's never there. He flies off all over the place. Mother's all right, I suppose.
Well, you don't sound too sure.
Well, I'm not definite, but I reckon something's a bit off.
What?
Well, I can't prove nothing, but that little kid's got bruises all over her body, and I don't reckon she got them falling down the stairs like her ma said.
Oh, no. Maxine, I've been in a similar situation before, and believe me, you have to tread very carefully.
And I know it.
Child bashing is very hard to prove. But if that little girl's in danger, you'll have to report it.
Yeah, but how am I going to get the proof?
Oh, well, that's terrific. I'm really grateful.
Keep it as long as you like. I only use it when I'm working on the boat and I've got a transistor I can use.
Thanks. Come in.
Ah, Neil. A message has just come through to reception. Dr. Williams is running late. He'll be here in about half an hour.
Oh, thanks. Oh, there's nothing urgent.
Who's the patient?
I'd like him to check Chrissie Latham. I think she might have a gynecological problem.
Oh, dear. It's a pity the department won't give us a resident gynecologist. I mean, you'd think it'd be essential in a women's prison with the amount of prostitutes we get in here. They always seem to be having trouble.
Yes, well, that's not really surprising. Still, you can hardly paint Chrissie with the same brush.
Oh, you're kidding. She's got a master's degree in prostitution.
She's this in for fiddling doll tricks, isn't she? Oh,
that's just her latest. I mean, she's been in for soliciting, well, a couple of times.
Oh, she never told me that.
You want to watch her, mate? She put the hard word on me once.
Joking?
Nah. When I knocked her back, she went straight to the governor crying rape. I'd watch her very carefully. She can't be trusted.
Unfortunately, he's right. Oh, I mean, Chrissie's changed a lot since she had a daughter. But she still thinks nothing of using a man for what she can get out of him.
Yes, I see what you mean, Mr. Murray. It does point to an ovarian cyst. But there are other possibilities which we must consider.
Yes, I thought she ought to be sent to the local hospital for the standard tests.
Yes, well, we're very limited in what we can do here. And I would like a biopsy.
Oh, blimey, Doc. I don't have to go to the hospital, do I?
I think it would be wise. I'll give you an examination while I'm here, but I don't expect to find anything. Mr. Murray's been very thorough in his care of you.
God, you're in a bad mood, the Savo Bee.
What do you expect, hanging around here waiting for those bastards on the parole board to decide whether they're going to let me out or not?
Oh, of course they're going to let you out. It isn't as if it's going to be for good. I mean, you still have to come back every night after work.
Yeah, but think of the rampage I could go on as soon as they open those gates. Oh, who am I kidding? They're not going to let me go. Of
course they will. You got to think positive. The parole board said they were going to review your case if you behaved yourself, and they can't say you haven't done that.
They haven't been caught anyway. Well, Dave, I did sound hopeful.
There you go, then.
One thing I regret is if they do let me out of here, I'm going to miss the fireworks.
What fireworks?
You know.
Oh, you mean when it hits the fan about Fergo?
Keep your voice down, Lizzie. I'm supposed to know.
Sorry, Bea, I forgot. How soon do you reckon it'll be?
Next pay-up delivery, I reckon. Faulkner will set her up to collect the cash. And as soon as she picks it up, there'll be screws coming out of the woodwork.
Oh, bloody good riddance to her, I say.
You'll make sure she gets to hospital all right then, won't you? And I look forward to seeing a copy of the test results.
Yes, of course.
Goodbye, Miss Latham. Don't upset yourself. There's no point in worrying about it until we know exactly what it is.
Yeah, ta. See ya.
Well, there you are. We've got you a day off.
Terrific. And what happens when the tests show that I've got nothing wrong with me?
Oh, one of the frustrations of medical science. But in the meantime, we'll have the afternoon together.
Are you going to come with me? Oh, that's great. Here, I wonder if they'll give me a private room.
Yes, well, I had something better in mind. You see, the head gynecologist at the General is a very good friend of mine, and he'll be able to cover your absence for a couple of hours so you can come to my place.
Oh, Neil, that'd be lovely, but look, I can't come. I'll have a guard on me.
No, it's all right. I've got it all worked out. Now, I used to work at the General, so I'll be able to tell you how to get out without being seen. And then we'll be able to have a couple of hours alone together. That's if you want it.
Oh, Neil, you know I do.
Well, I'll draw you a map.
Miss Ferguson. I'd like to have a word with you.
You are?
I want my papers back, and I'm prepared to pay for them.
What with?
Your job.
You're not making much sense, Fields.
If I tell you what I know, will you give me the papers back?
All right. If I think it's worth it.
B. Smith's running a racket with Mr. Faulkner to get buyout goods for the women.
So what?
All the goods come through the buyout order.
Well, I didn't think Mr. Faulkner paid for them out of his own pocket. That's yesterday's news, Fields.
Yeah, well, whatever kind of deal it is, Mrs. Morris and Mrs. Powell are in on it too. It's true. Mrs. Morris helped him carry the stuff in, and Mrs. Powell countersigned the requisition. And I overheard B. Smith mention something about a set. Miss Ferguson? Well, what about my papers?
Oh, I don't know, love. It's a hell of a risk. I mean, if I get caught, they're not going to believe I'm just nicking off for a couple of hours, are they? I'll get another escape charge laid on me, and that'll really bugger up my chances of getting Elizabeth back.
Now, trust me, Chrissie, the doctor will cover for you. No one will know you've gone.
He must be a really good friend of yours if he's going to risk helping a prisoner.
I'll have some clothes hidden for you, and I'll be outside waiting in the car. Mm-hmm. Well, what do you say? Come in.
Oh, I just saw Dr. Williams leave and thought Chrissie might be ready to go back.
Well, yes, she is Mrs. Morris. I was just explaining to her about the test she'll have to undergo.
Yeah, not too keen on hospitals.
Well, who is? Come on, Chrissie, ready?
Yeah. Thanks, Mr. Murray. I really appreciate it.
Excuse me, Governor. I must see you for a moment. It's very important.
Certainly, Miss Ferguson. What is it?
It seems that some of the women have had a large amount of cigarettes and buy-up goods lately. Far too much, considering that you stopped buy-up for a week as punishment.
Oh?
Well, I've been keeping my ear to the ground, and frankly, I'm shocked at what I've found out.
And what is that?
God knows how long they've been getting away with it. Governor, I don't like reporting fellow officers, but obviously something must be done about it. It seems that two of the officers, including the deputy governor herself, have been stealing goods from the prison and selling them to the women.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.